So if you've got students doing research, the app Article Search is a fantastic tool. It simplifies the search down from just a broad Google search to article-specific searches of the Microsoft Academic database and the Google Scholar database, as well as a whole range of other more specific topic databases as well. Let's have a look. So this is the main screen that you see when you open Article Search. You can see that you're searching for Google Scholar and Microsoft Academic catalogs. Basically, you need to put in a search term, so topical at the moment, Ebola, I'm going to search for that one. You can leave the author's name blank and the years. So click on search. It tells you how many articles you'll see in Google Scholar and also in Microsoft Academia. If you click on one of those, it basically lists the articles down the right-hand side there. You can go through and have a look at a particular article. So let's pull up this one. It'll load the article, and then you can click on the plus tab, and you can save it to your favorites, send by email or send by SMS. So I'll click on save to favorites. So click that, there we go. So that's got your article details. You can click through on the links on this page. So it's active links, and you have a forward and back button as well. So click on the backwards tab, you'll go back through the pages, and you can get back to your search results. Now, if you put in multiple search terms, obviously you'll refine your results. We added one article to the favorites, so Ebola there. I'd already done one earlier. You can sort your favorites via chronological order in which they were added, A to Z, Z to A, so some simple search options there. Now, this app is free to start with, and it gives you those two main databases. If you go into the Settings tab, you can turn either of those libraries on or off. You can actually go and access premium libraries. So on the free version, you can only access one premium library at a time. But for example, if I want to look at something chemistry related, I can go to PubChem and add that library to my search results. So if we go back here, you now see that we've got a third library. You'll notice that if you try and tick more than one, it says, basically tells you you have to pay if you want to do more than one library. Okay, so you could search different libraries, but you'd have to tag and then untag and go in and out. But I'll do that for now. So I'll just show you the different search results we get there. So I actually now work with a teacher who has done her doctorate and she's got some published papers. If I go and search for that, I'll actually find the references there. It was biochemistry was her field, so you can see a lot of references in that field for that teacher. And I look through and you can see her name targeted and the research that she was involved in. So that's fantastic. Just as a contrast, if I go and remove that particular library and then I redo that search, you'll notice that just with Google Scholar and the Microsoft Academic, I miss out on a lot of the main articles that particular researchers were involved in certain fields. So a great way to refine your search a little bit more.